Heyo, Saki Knight here, and welcome to Saki vs. Steam. Today we're going to be playing The First Tree. The first thing I notice is that my recording isn't showing the background on this main screen. So I'm hoping that's just a graphical glitch for right now, and it won't affect the actual game. Let me just see if I can turn down the audio. Nope. Okay. Oh, there. You can see it. No. Yeah, I am somewhat worried that this entire recording might just get scuffed. That is kind of loud. Hold on. Where's my cursor? Alright, just gonna have to deal with that for right now. Hold on. There we go. Let me just turn this down. That should help. What's commentary mode? No. Let's not do that right now.
Are you awake? I thought I heard you get up.
Still kind of loud.
I'm awake. Sorry, I just can't sleep.
Are you thinking about him?
Yeah, a bit. Usually get back to sleep.
Still kind of loud. What were those controls? Well, I missed it.
I don't know. It seems weird, but I had one of the most vivid dreams of my life. I saw a fox on a snowy mountain, just looking confused and worried. Those eyes. I can't get those eyes out of my head. She was running in the windy snow, looking for something.
Do you think it has to do with you and what's been going on?
I don't know. It was just a dream, Rachel. They're not meant to make sense. A lot's happened the past couple days, that's all.
Well, if you're not going to sleep anyway, you should tell me. I want to hear.
All right.
Oh, this fox can fly. Alright, so it's gonna be one of these, kind of like art piece story games, I guess. Rather than some sort of action kind of game. Possibly gonna be some puzzles, but I get the feeling that's mostly just gonna be me walking around and them narrating to me. Oh no.
So not far from her home, she followed that path to something unexpected.
Rest in peace, little fox. Rest in peace.
She couldn't stay though. She had to find her other two children. So she took that path. She followed it towards something ancient. Something with answers.
The first tree. I remember my first tree.
The fox looked high and low, searching for any sign of her cubs. Points of light showed the way to this ancient tree. It was as if each one had a story to tell, all their own. The land was trying to tell my story, too. I felt like I was right behind her the whole time.
But we are right behind her the whole time. That's how third-person camera works. Ooh, what's that? There's a thing here. There's so much stuff. I get the feeling that this is gonna get real deep, real fast.
As a kid, did you ever do show and tell in your class?
Yeah, I think I only did it once, when I was in the fourth grade. You know how my life was around then. I wanted to show my class what helped pass the time and distracted me. So I brought a dozen paper cranes I had. I think I told everyone how badly I wanted to be a bird and fly, embarrassingly enough.
Don't be embarrassed. Every kid wants to fly. For me, it was another toy for my dad, a wooden boat. I remember guarding it so carefully in my hands as I walked into class. When I sat down, a group of boys immediately made fun of it. They asked which trash can I found it in, or why an ugly log was my favorite toy. When I got up, I didn't even want to tell them my dad had carved it. I said it was a joke gift my friends had given me.
Kids can be so cruel.
Some of them are. I shouldn't have let them get to me, but it did. It's amazing we bounced back at all.
I missed some shinies up top.
Do you remember what my dad did for a living?
Wasn't he like a lumberjack?
That's one way of putting it. Wood was a canvas, and a carving knife was his paintbrush. Even after working a 50-hour week, even after his hands were more splinters than skin, he would bring home the nicest piece of Alaskan weeping cedar and make me toys. That wooden train was
the... You missed the from the lumberyard part.
I just knew from a young age I was going to be a lumberjack, like my father.
Subtitles don't match with the audio. Questionable. No, where's my double jump? Chinese. I can't tell if that's a light showing me a thing. I think it is. Yeah. Is that a tank?
Usually those kids would leave me alone, but somehow they could tell I was different. They made fun of how far away I lived. They called my dad a sourdough. I was a blabbermouth as a kid, telling my dad stories I made up for hours. But after that show and tell, I didn't tell him much anymore. He didn't know exactly what was wrong, but his best guess was that the toys he carved weren't cool enough. He carved me a tank and tried to tell me what it was like to be in a real tank as a serviceman.
I didn't know your dad was in the military.
Yeah, in the army. The sad thing is that I pretty much forgot him until just now. So much I still don't know about him.
I'm sorry. He knows how much you love him. You're going to see him again soon and have some closure, I'm sure.
Why would you set up that death flag all of a sudden? That's not cool. Did I miss another thing over there? What? No, I think I didn't. Maybe I didn't. Oh, I almost definitely missed something over there, huh?
Something special about having a place to call your own.
And now look at us. Well, you count renting in an overpriced city.
It's as close as we can get for now.
America! Shiny boys, come here, shiny boy. I know there's definitely things that I missed down there, but I'm gonna keep going this way. Springtime.
Teenage years were full of sketching, angst, and trouble. I wasn't popular or unpopular. Maybe just forgettable. I guess that gave me a sense of freedom. So I hung out with crazy kids, doing crazy things, even though I mostly just watched the chaos ensue. We did it all. Put fireworks in mailboxes, hide roadkill in people's garages, break windows of the barbershop in Anchorage. My dad was furious. But he was so busy working, he couldn't do much to stop me from going out.
I think being an adult means there's no one to stop you making hard decisions. He had to make a living, and he couldn't be in two places at once.
Yeah, I realize that now. But at the time, I was sure he was more interested in growing his business than what was going on with me. He was working another late night, and my friends were over, saying how bored they were, and how they had come all the way out to my house for nothing. One of them mentioned how that old, ugly beyond belief truck was still in the garage, and how we should take it for a spin. I was only 15, so I kind of fought it for a while. The next thing I knew, we were careening around the mountain path, rocks spitting onto the sides of the cliff, while my dad's cringeworthy bluegrass blared out the speakers. I drove while my friends were in the back of that yellow and purple truck, throwing beer bottles and trash at anything remotely interesting. It felt like I was soaring in the air with borrowed wings. But all good things have endings. A cop outside of Eagle River pulled us over after he saw us in a bottle rocket into someone's yard. What followed was a long night of talking to disappointed adults and feeling smaller than ever.
You ever just go joyriding in your dad's old truck? Me neither. Oh, man. This is the most work I've had to put in to watch a movie, with the exception of every single Metal Gear Solid game. On to the next section. I see. Oh, hey, there's the old pickup truck. Oh, where? Are we going up into the waterfall? Okay. Well, that's a little disappointing. I don't see any butterflies. I don't want to get all the way over there. I need to come all the way back. No, I need all the butterflies. I had to go back anyway. Why would you do this to me, Jace? Oh, hey, a shiny. Nice. There it is.
And I laughed along, pretending it didn't bother me. But it did. I imagined my friends growing old in the bush, unable to find that thrill in those godforsaken ice fields. like those mountains were a literal wall, keeping me from leaving, where all I would have to look forward to are lumber yards and evening beers. I had to climb over.
Not even gonna try.
My goal for a long time.
Not even gonna try to grab that one.
Some way I could take my love of drawing and turn it into a way of escape. Nothing would make me happier. I wanted to create instead of tearing trees down. I wanted to move to the lower 48, not because I hated it there in Alaska, but I hated the idea of it. It's like all of that spite inside me had created this monster which followed me around my whole teenage years. I put so much energy into doing what others didn't expect of me. Why did I do that?
There's one fact you're forgetting, though. If you didn't have that fire in you, we probably would have never met.
You're absolutely right. Maybe the destination is all that matters in the end. Then why am I awake? Why am I seeing this fox go on her journey? And why can't I stop thinking about my dad?
Oh, it's getting dark. Is that the ancient tree?
He was just dense. Eventually, to shut him up, I agreed. We carried out the worn lawn chairs from the garage and set up a cinder block campfire at the site we'd always used behind the house. We walked down the mountain path, talking in the warm sunshine we only got a couple months of the year. Those three obsidian rocks shimmered alongside the shore, almost like sparklers pressed against a dark window. I'll never forget that wet stone on my feet, or how those massive mountains looked even bigger in the lake's reflection. I felt small, but grateful.
Oh, no.
As the sun set, my dad found something I hadn't seen for a long time. The tree where I'd made my first carving when I was 6.
Oh, good.
I hadn't even carved it.
I thought it was another dead fox.
I still called it my tree. Something about seeing my name there made me open up. And we talked about everything that night in that old camouflage tent. I told him how much I love sketching and design, and how it would be a dream to study architecture in Seattle. I told him how I didn't get along with my friends much anymore, but that I didn't mind being alone. He told me he was there for me, and he joked that if all he had to do was write my name on a tree to finally get me to talk, he would have left me carved logs with novels on them in front of my room every morning. I don't know why it took me that long to realize it, but it was then I knew how much he had sacrificed for me. On our property, there were old abandoned pieces of a shed and car long left unused. I used to ask him all the time who those people were that left all this junk, and I'm sure he got so tired of hearing it that he made up some elaborate stories how a brown bear ate them and haunted the woods after. What's funny is I think it made those people seem more real. Growing up thinking they were still hanging out, like they couldn't say goodbye. I used to tell my friends how I could swear I saw spirits move near the water, and that always freaked them out. I guess it didn't bother me, because the way I saw it, they were normal people with old cars and sheds, just trying to figure out how to survive and be happy. was a cool thought that they didn't want to leave, but, you know, I was a weird kid.
Well, you had good company since those ghosts liked living in a place where they were brutally devoured.
Yikes. Leave in the comments if you ever hang out with people that have been brutally eaten by a bear. There we go. Right. Why not? How do I? There we go. It was a stubborn one. And that's a broken fox. Boy, it gets real quiet when he stops telling the story, huh? But it is quite pretty. Very relaxing. Though, I do have to be honest, this is not the only recording I've tried to do today. There was another game that I had played called Midnight Protocol. It was a game about hacking that, as I was playing it, I realized I personally didn't think it was very entertaining to watch. Wasn't even that great to play. Because it's not that it was a bad game, it's just it felt very dry. You know? But I think I might just pin the short recording I did of that to the end of this. And you guys can feel free to tell me if you would like to see more of that and or this. Additionally, if you want to find out what unlocking that third stone light does, feel free to pick up the first tree on Steam yourself or at your other game website. Others are available. But that's where I'm going to leave the first tree myself for now. So let's play some games again next time. Bye! So after some careful consideration during the editing process, I decided to not tag the other game onto the back end of this. So as always, enjoy the rest of your day. Bye.